you heard it, folks. And we told you that this area is tops for golf, but also for chess. It's true. We're going to explain why. Chess, Todd. And there'll be plenty of Bigfoot sightings from Chess to Bigfoot here in Cumberland County. We're going to explain how and when.
Absolutely. And we couldn't spend time here in Cumberland County and Crossville without recognizing one of the top draws for this region, the Cumberland County Playhouse.
Yeah, its history dates back 5 decades, and its future looks bright thanks to the dedicated folks who work behind the curtain. It's a place that offers comedy, drama, and plenty of talent. The Cumberland County Playhouse is one of Tennessee's largest professional theaters.
The Playhouse has been around since 1965, which is an amazing thing to still see.
Bryce McDonald started out as an intern. He's now the producing director and CEO.
We have a resident company of professional actors from across the U.S. with a artisan crew of carpenters, technicians, designers, in costume sets, props, and lights of 16, and then an administrative staff of 16.
The Playhouse would never have had an opening act had it not been for a tremendously talented couple who had found fame and work outside these mountains.
Paul and Mary Crabtree started the Playhouse. They were both Broadway stars. They'd met in New York. They had done a tour of a comedy called Show and Tell, and they fell in love.
The Crabtrees came to Cumberland County to relax and refocus, but pretty soon the people in the area were asking for their help.
Paul was going to write a book, and somebody said, "We know you're in the arts. We don't have the arts here in Cumberland County. Will you teach a class?" And he said, "Sure." And from that class, he decided to put on a play called The Perils of Pinocchio. It had 100 children in it. Right after Christmas of 63, somebody said to him, "How do we keep something like this in Cumberland County?" And he jokingly said, "Build me a theater." A year later, they built our main stage for him, and they've stayed ever since.
The Crabtrees nurtured the talent here, and with every new production came a newfound love of the arts.
When it first started, they were not able to pay everyone to be here. So Paul Crabtree, he held acting classes. There would be doctors and lawyers and teachers were playing these leads and shows as he was trying to build the reputation of this company.
And the family also celebrated all artists and their talents.
They were some of the first businesses in Cumberland County that hired people of color or someone that was not white. And in 1965 through... well, sadly through today, that is a huge deal.
The Crabtree's son, Jim, kept his parents' legacy going for years before retiring. Today, the theater is forging a new path with new faces alongside the familiar ones.
All of our people, I will proudly say, could go on to other bigger cities, but they have chosen to make Crossville and the Upper Cumberland and Tennessee their home, and they want to keep fighting to bring arts to this area. And that is outstanding to me.